Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. Now, before we get started in today's video, I want to talk about Level Up Gaming. I got one of these shirts right here. They sent to me a couple weeks ago. They sent me a message to sponsor them, and that's what I'm doing, sponsoring them. I like pretty much everything they have on their website right now. If you want to check them out, check the description box below at levelupgamingapparel.com. And when you go there, tell them that your favorite random man sent you there. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and children of all ages. Of course, I'm your favorite random man, future king of YouTube. Terrence was in this here building today. And how you guys doing? So, guys, this is my 202 reaction to things. And don't you know what reaction to is? You should know what reaction to is because it's the name and the title. But pretty much what I do, I like to do reaction to trailers, anime. And I sometimes I do my best to do a good full review of some of the videos and stuff that I watch. So as you know, last week we got the trailer to the Mortal Kombat reboot, and seeing that trailer, I'm really excited for this movie. But there are things I do want to talk about. But before we talk about it, let's go through this reaction together, because I know a lot of you guys want me to do this reaction. And I am going to do this reaction, but before we go on again, guys, make sure you give me a like, share, subscribe, tell your friends. It really helps me out, guys. You know, we at like 209. Now let everybody know where we at, who you supporting. Love you guys. I hope one thing I get my homeboy, my main man, Corey S. Kenshin. I know he's here. He recently just dropped a spooky, scary Sunday video. But anyways, enough about that. Let me stop the talking, and let's get to the watch.
Had to make sure.
Hey guys. Thank you.
First learned about this 7 years ago on a mission in Brazil to capture a war.
So, you know, the first time I watched this trailer, guys, I didn't know that was Jax.
It tore through our unit in seconds.
Bruh. Oh my god. Cole, I'm gonna talk about Cole. When I get to the end of this.
He was born with it.
It's not a birthmark, Cole. It means you've been chosen.
Cause that's Melina. God, this movie was so beautiful, man.
Reference a great tournament.
Is that rating on the right side? Okay, I'm gonna look at that in a minute. Okay, I'm gonna look at that in a minute.
To fight for something known.
God, bruh. I'm sorry I forget his name, but God, the way he playing Scorpion looks so amazing. April 16th. We ain't got long. I got questions about that too. Liu Kang. Jax. Kung Lao. Bruh.
The fate of Earth is in our hands.
Oh boy. I get goosebumps. Look at Scorpion, bruh.
We will not fail.
Look at that statue of Shao Kahn. Okay, that's Reptile. Those you didn't read, that was actually Reptile. But I'm gonna do like a skip frame by frame type of thing. Gordon looks nice. God, look at Sub.
I am so
God, it's amazing. I love this movie, man. I love it. Wait, who's Scorpion fighting? Okay. Oh, guy. Okay, guys. I got this. We're gonna do a frame by frame. But my thing is with Cole and the director, he did like a secret reveal kind of frame by frame, like who's who was what. But like Cole is supposed to be, I guess us, sort of say, because those who remember, I want to say Deadly Alliance, Deception, in Armageddon, where you're this character, this new character comes into Mortal Kombat, and you doing this little storyline for it, like Taven was trying to Shujinko, because I actually love the character Shujinko, where he was tricked by the Dragon Lord and he's trying to get all these powers and all the powers of the other combatants, stuff like that. So, and I remember what the director was saying about Cole. He was pretty much saying with Cole, he's phone call, guys, excuse me, we have le phone call. I love my friends, I really do. So anyways, like what the director was saying, that Mortal Kombat brings in new characters just about almost every iteration of the game. And he's right, Mortal Kombat do that, but why create your own characters? And this is my red flag with this film, because you're bringing in a new character that we don't know nothing about, and it scares me. Look what happened with Resident Evil, where I said so many multiple times, the first film of Resident Evil was great, I loved it, and the story was setting up. Then afterwards, every character took the back seat to Alice. Now, is it fair that I'm comparing this movie to Resident Evil? Yes and no, but But at the same time, I feel like you bring in a new character along with these classic characters. Are these characters going to take a back seat to Cole? That's the one thing that really got me on the fence and got me a little bit skeptical. But because at first I thought he was like Kung Lao for a second, but then I started thinking about maybe he's the son of Kenshi, or maybe one of my buddies said he might be related to Scorpion, or possibly, yeah, they say like Scorpion or something like that. Shit right here, that's supposed to be Cole or ancestors of Cole, so I don't know. And I wonder, this is what I'm wondering here, so because again, I really don't want to make this too long, so I'm wondering, this is where Sub and Scorpion fights, because you see all the icicles and everywhere and stuff like that. So that looked real nice, I like that. I'm kind of intrigued by it, but I'm gonna go right here with what happened with Jax, because and the director said this, and this is really true as well. I know that's so much really bothering you guys. I'm so sorry. But I remember what he said. Let me stop it right there. Like, because I can't remember how in the original time, I can't remember how Jax lost his arms. But you ever watch the Scorpion's Revenge, the Mortal Kombat animated movie? Goro took his arms. Then I think in Mortal Kombat 9, I want to say Ermite took his arm. So seeing Sub-Zero, like, again, Jax's arms, it's their own way of saying that. And I had no issue with that, because I didn't know that was Jax there for a hot minute. So that was pretty, cool, man. There you go. Okay, so, first of all, those are Kitana's fans right there. I never noticed that. So, this is my thing. Now, because there go Cole again. So, this is my, alright, so, I think one of my buddies said, yes, Sonya Blade and Kato dated. I know opposites attract. I know opposites attract, but bruh, come on. Kato and Sonya Blade, and I get it, there is multiple timelines in the Mortal Kombat mythos, but bruh, no. And seeing, what I'm thinking, this again, I had a discussion with a friend of mine. What we were talking about is, maybe this is where Kano formed the Black Dragon, or maybe some type of way, like, Sonya got something on Kano where he had no choice to work with Sonya and Jack. So I don't know. And, like, why would Kano? I feel like Kano's going to betray them in the long run, thinking about this, watching this trailer all over again. So that's my guesses, and that's what I'm assuming that's going to happen. But I know I talk about Cole, but I'm going to say it again. You got Liu Kang and Kung Lao. Why is Cole this new character? And what I'm afraid of is Cole is supposed to be the new character. I don't want to see that. I don't want to see it. You got Liu Kang in here, bruh. There's no need for that. Go back just a little bit more. Okay, I feel like this is Cole right here. I really feel like this is Cole. And first of all, I love how Goro looks. I love how Goro looks. Goro looks amazing. Because I remember, I can't remember what people he worked with. Director talked about for helping with the CGI stuff. But he definitely did say that, making multi-lin-like characters for here was kind of hard because you want to make sure everything's right on point. Like I said, Goro looks nice. Like, I feel like this is Cole right here. Or this could be before the tournament for this year's tournament. Sorry, you know, in Mortal Kombat, it's like if I win 10 tournaments, you know, they get a Earth Realm. But I really think this is Cole. This is during the match, because again, the one thing we don't see in this trailer, we don't see Sub-Zero is the guy who was on the first Raid Redemption movie. God, that movie was so good, and he does a good job with Sub-Zero. Now, they're saying that Sub-Zero may be the main bad guy, maybe the main antagonist. But if that was the case, why you need Shang Tsung? I think with Bi-Han, this is what I'm thinking. I think he is a bad guy in this, no doubt about it. He's a bad guy in my mind. But the main tag is, I don't see it. I really don't. But I gotta watch this fight scene again, because that guy thought that fight scene was beautiful. Oh, that was beautiful. Okay, hold on. I love that too. Now, I'm thinking right there, that looks like Cole again, guys. That looks like Cole. I wish we can, I don't know. I'm really speculating that. I want to think that's Cole right there. Because he got the same armor piece as Goro. I mean, as the dude fighting Goro. Yeah, because see the armor right here? I think that this guy is possibly as Cole fighting Goro. That's what I'm thinking. That's what I'm believing. But oh my god, I think this one's going to be so freaking amazing. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this reaction to. Again, make sure you like, share, subscribe, tell your friends about me. Come to the rant site. We do have those cookies. And hashtag Meet Corey's Kitchen. That's one of my dreams and my goals. And I believe my heart says it's going to happen. But anyways, so man, tell me in the comments, guys. Tell me what you're saying. Tell me your theories. Again, this is only the first trailer. I'm sure we're going to get more next month sometime. Maybe showing a little bit more. Because again, overall, the movie itself looks banging. It's slapping. I love it. It's just Cole who I have an issue with. But anyways, please, I'm going to say it again. Please, you guys stay random. I will see you all in the next video. Love you and deuces.